Hello friends, and welcome to Droom Discovery. What we have with us is probably the most talked about and the most awaited car of 2019, the Hyundai Venue. This was launched a few days back with prices starting at 6.5 lakh rupees ex showroom daily. This is Hyundai's entry into the world of sub 4 meter compact SUVs. The segment is currently ruled by the Brezza, and of course we have options like the EcoSport, the XV300, the Nexon. What we have with us is the top-end petrol automatic version, which comes in the SX Plus, not in the SX option, but I would say the SX Plus. But visually this one looks similar to the top end of the manual Venues. Now, a lot has been said about the way this car looks, so we'll keep this simple and sweet. No doubt the front is the talking point about the Venue. It looks aggressive, it looks modern, it looks bold. A lot of adjectives will be used for this car when you see it in flesh. Of course, the talking point here is the huge grille, which is laden with chrome. I think we Indians love chrome, and this one has that in abundance. And then you have these sharp indicators. A lot of people will say that the design of the indicators is inspired by the Harrier, but no, the development for the Venue started a couple of years back. You know, you remember the Carlino concept at the 2016 Auto Expo. Since then the design development started, so there is no resemblance or copying from the Harrier, nothing about that. Of course, then you have these lovely DRLs. They are flickering in the video because we are unable to capture the frames properly, but of course they don't flicker in real life. And then the best in segment LED fog lamps below in the bumper. You also have these silver inserts on the lower side of the bumper. We call them the skid plates, not really functional. Anyways, if you go on the side, the top end models come with these lovely machined alloy wheels. They look nice, and our test car currently has MRF tires, of course 16 inches, both front and rear. Side profile is a lot similar to the Creta, and that's a family resemblance. You see the car from the side and you can actually make out the resemblance. It looks like a younger sibling of the Creta. At the back, again, we aren't able to capture the frames properly. The screen, the flickering will come. The tail lamps do look nice. It's a sweet, simple execution at the back. And doesn't look very muscular or bold at the front, but nevertheless, it's a clean and tidy rear. This is a turbocharged model, so you have the turbo badge right here. The SX, not the O, remember, SX Plus. And of course, the Venue logo. Roof-mounted rails, they do look nice. And if I touch them, yes, they can take some amount of load and beating. So overall, in white color, I think the Venue looks nice. The black cladding on the side, the machined alloy wheels, the lovely front, and the neat and clean rear. On the inside, well, this is an overly black theme with clever silver inserts here and there. It gets a push button start. And of course, we have this huge screen, which Hyundai claims offers you almost like best-in-class touch reception, and even the size is quite generous. Down here, you have the climate control knobs. This is for operating the speed, which displays over here. If I increase the fan speed, you can see. And likewise, this is to adjust the temperature settings. Looks retro cool. I think Maruti offerings have such design. Works well in my opinion. Feature loaded this car definitely. This is for your wireless charging. This is a quick charger, then more slots for your smartphones. We are in the automatic version, so it comes with a 6-speed DCT. And of course, you have a lot of storage spaces right over here. This is the setup for the car purifier, which is offered to customers. It's not right here in our test car. So space here, space over here and space over here to key the key fob. The key, by the way, looks like this. Quite nice. You can just leave it here. You also have this armrest with storage space. It's not adjustable in the automatic one. You have more space to probably keep your wallet right over here like this. And you have space for your documents or other stuff. The doors, the door pads are generous. They can hold a bottle which is of 1 liter very easily and still have space over here. And of course, we have the sunroof in the automatic version, which opens like a conventional way. There you go. We are in a test car by a dealership, so the speedometer is currently locked. Can't show you that, but I can definitely show you the steering controls for your volume, for changing the track, the mode, the voice commands on the right side for your cruise control, and toggling between the display on the console over there. So overall, I would say the interiors are well put together. The quality is decently nice for the segment. Hard plastics, they will wear down very well. This area has your leather. The seats don't get leather, but the stitching is very nice. You can see contrast stitching on the back as well, and they hug you nicely. These supports are something that we have loved on the EcoSport, and even this case it's nice. The under thigh support is also good. Some cars come with a small under thigh support which is not too generous, but this one, even for people who have a large frame, it's quite nice. So good things up front. Let's have a look at the back. So this is the view that passengers will get from the rear of the venue. I would say visibility is not bad. Even the windows, they roll down completely flat. There you go. So they're rolling down completely flat. That's a good plus point. You do get rear AC vents right over here. You can adjust the airflow from here and the vents for both the passengers. Now, this seat has been positioned for a driver who's 5'11". I stand 6 feet tall, and you can see there is a good 2 inches of gap in the knee room. Not bad. Likewise, you know, when you open the doors, you're going to get inside. The doors do open quite wide, so getting in and out of the venue is not an issue. Again, you have place to keep a 1 liter bottle over here. Probably keep a mobile phone here. One thing that is definitely missing in the automatic version is a central armrest, which the manual one gets. But of course, you have a generous and a large usable parcel tray over here. Very useful on the move, especially with kids. The sunroof comes in here, so you have the airiness. So overall, I would say in terms of space, features, the design, it should score approximately 8 marks out of 10. Now the venue comes with 350 liters of boot space. We have a lot of shooting stuff over here, from a tripod, sliders, our riders, helmets, to drones, to cameras. So you can see the depth of this boot is very, very impressive for what is a sub 4 meter SUV. 350 liters of boot space, really impressive for a vehicle of this segment. As I told you, it comes with a parcel tray which is quite big and usable. You can see it goes all the way down. Unfortunately, the automatic version does not get a 60-40 split, which the manual one does, because again, the automatic is not offered in the SXO. Anyways, that was the interior. We are done with the exteriors. Let's talk about the engine of the venue. The biggest question that people have in mind right now is about the performance of the 1.0 DCT combination. On paper, this engine makes a very impressive 120 PS of power and a healthy dose of torque, 172 Newton meters. In reality, does this work out well? Oh yes, definitely. And a big reason for this is the dual clutch transmission. It's a 7-speed setup, and the first time you are seeing such an advanced transmission in the segment. The dual clutch system ensures minimal lags during gear changes, which in turn increases acceleration. And all this without sacrificing on the ever important fuel economy part. We spent a good amount of time with the venue automatic, and the impression was very positive. Pedal to metal, the gearbox takes a fraction of a second to downshift a gear or two and gain momentum. Yes,
the three-cylinder engine doesn't sound the best, but when driven in a relaxed manner, the combination works very, very well. In terms of dynamics, the light steering is our favorite and provides ease of driving. All this without sacrificing on dynamics at higher speeds. This top spec model comes with 16-inch tires, and the ride quality is a good compromise between comfort and agility. Road noise is well damped, and only larger potholes throw you around in a discomfort manner. For daily drives though, the venue will keep customers very happy. Aiding this driving pleasure is excellent visibility all around.